Hey everyone, this is Tina with Overall Adventures. Thank you so much for joining me. Today is a pretty special video because I'm doing a cool collaboration with Francesco. You should go check him out, subscribe to him in the link below. I promise you're going to love him. And now let me tell you why. So as you guys know, on my channel, I do a lot of talking about journaling, which is awesome. And I am basically like an old woman and love to write with just pen and paper. That's my thing, right? Well, do you know that there is like a whole world of people who journal online and use awesome apps and things like that to journal online? Makes sense, but I don't know anything about it. So Francesco is gonna come on here today and talk to you guys about the best apps that you can use for documenting your life, your memories, going through all the things that I talk about on my channel, but via apps, your phone, and the internet. Brilliant, love it. He does a lot of videos on productivity and reviewing different apps, and I just love the way that he brings together kind of technology and a productive, healthy, well-balanced life into his channel, so you should definitely go check him out. I will be over on his channel talking about just the basics of beginning a journal, and so you can go check me out over there as well. Francesco will be in the comments below to answer any questions that you guys might have, because I probably don't know them because I don't know too much about apps. But without further ado, welcome Francesco to my channel.
Hello everyone, it is Francesco here. Thank you very much to Tina for introducing me. That's very kind of her, and having me here on the channel as well. She'll be over on my channel very, very soon talking about how to start a journal for beginners, a physical journal that is. Now I'll be over here today talking a little bit about the digital side of stuff. I wanted to recommend a few useful applications that you can use for journaling as well. Now, of course, there are plenty of amazing physical solutions out there. I actually have my own physical journal. I use this lovely Baron Fig Confidant notebook that's just great. And I write like a full paragraph in the morning, and I get through these quite fast. I get through like one every 3 months or 4 months on average. And it's brilliant to have a physical journal. I love doing it in the morning. It's just something about writing and actually like doing something offline, it's quite exciting. But there are plenty of journal applications available on lots of different devices. So what I wanted to do today is recommend 5 for you. So what I'll be doing is I'll put them all in the description below so that you guys can go away and check them out. And I'll also be available in the comments after the video as well if you have any questions or queries about this whole digital journaling experience. So the first one I'd like to recommend is a really simple one. It's called Bear. Now this is very popular at the moment, mainly because it's got quite a nice design. It allows you to organize different notes using hashtags, which is quite a cool concept. For journaling, it's really simple. You can just use it as a way to document your stuff on Mac and iOS. Now it's really easy to get started. All you have to do is create that hashtag journal section and just start typing away. You can add images, you can add links, you can add all sorts of different documents as well if you wish to add that different layer to the journal. But what I really like about it and why I recommend it is it's distraction free. It just has this really lovely window that you can just start typing away on, and the application on the iPhone just looks great. So that's my first recommendation. My second recommendation is actually something that is a bit more structured. This is called the 5-minute journal, and you may have heard of this. This is actually a technique used by someone called Tim Ferriss in a process called morning pages. Now, there are obviously lots of connotations of morning pages. People use it as a way to start their day by writing, which is a beautiful way. And I believe Tina has talked about this in the past. Now, the 5-minute journal is a physical book. It's an app as well. And the app actually allows you to do the same as the physical book. You start the day by capturing 3 things that you are grateful for, and then 3 things that you'll be working on today. Now, this is a great way to start the day, and in the app, you get that panel, and it looks fantastic. And then when you end the day, you review your day by reviewing what you got done, and also things you're grateful for, and going over that process so you sort of feel a bit more confident. As I said, it's a bit more structured, but it's actually a very popular way. to keep yourself really focused and keep reviewing all of the stuff that you're happy and not so happy with in life. The third recommendation is called Memento. This is actually available on Android and iOS, but it provides you with a really clean and easy to use journaling experience. It's like a diary. It actually just allows you to put entries in, adding things like location, images, details of the day, and even adding context around your day, which is really fun. So it's a great way to capture those moments across your day and bring them together in a diary. Now, number four is very, very similar. It's called Day One, and it's probably the leading application. It's available on Android, iOS, and Mac, so you can write pretty much anywhere. The application has a premium experience, but it has a freemium experience as well, so you can go in and use it up to a certain amount. But the application itself is fantastic. You can log, as I said, anything from images, details like that, and you can capture context like location and tags and running and whether you were doing stuff across the day, the weather. It's really detailed in what you can add to it, but it's just a gorgeous looking application for you to start bringing all of your stuff together. And the great thing is it's got a gallery, so you can go back and actually see day by day all of the photos that you took and sort of create those really beautiful memories. So if you wanted some sort of journaling experience that had images and visuals, that's a great experience. And my final recommendation, this is just available for Mac, but the Lifecraft application is pretty good. You can just use it as a journaling application. It's very similar to Day One, very colorful, allowing you to add really nice setup with the whole like typing away experience. But what it does is allows you to actually track your emotions as well by capturing them in emoji format, which is really cool because what that will do over time is detect and track your mood and essentially help provide you with ways to improve your mood and further extend that, which is fantastic. But it also, I tend to do this in my journal, is actually write down a few moods that I'm having in a day. And this helps me when I go back to actually go, okay, I was actually in this sort of mood that day. I can go back to that state and be like, okay, I've improved from there, or I've learned something, or maybe that was not a good time for me. And that helps people to move forward. So guys, I hoped that you enjoyed these five apps. You can download them all in the description below. And as I said, I'm available in the comments to communicate with you guys. Over on my YouTube very soon, Tina will be over there talking about how to use journals for beginners, which I'm really excited about because my community also loves productivity apps and also these sort of journaling self-development experiences. So if you want to join me over on YouTube, it'd be amazing to have you. Come over, join the Keep Productive community, and there'll be loads of you guys, loads of stuff to do over there. So feel free to join them. Anyway guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Thank you very much for Tina for having me and a lovely introduction. I've been in touch with Tina and she was really excited that I was able to share these, and I'm equally as excited to have her over on my channel. Anyway guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, keep journaling, and I'll see you guys very soon. Cheers.